presents Jile Zindagi with Anju Malhotra, concept by Haima Khan, only on TV 4. Thank you very much. You have liked my other shows before, our opening number, and also the Christmas show. Lot of people have emailed us, lot of people have called us, inboxed me. I couldn't respond to all of you, but thank you so much for writing to me and telling me how nice this show is and how much you have liked it. It really encourages us, encourages our whole team. And you know, this year we are bringing some new things in this show to bring you more and more information, more and more fun, and beautiful guests where you will learn from every guest we will bring. They are remarkable people and they have done wonders in their lives. So this year, stay tuned with us. We're going to bring you a lot of different variety. कहते हैं जिंदगी कितने साल की है ये मायने नहीं रखता, जिंदगी कितने साल जी है ये मायने रखता है. और जब हम जिंदगी की बात करते हैं तो रोटी कपड़ा मकान के बाद सबसे ज़्यादा इंसान के लिए ज़रूरी है प्यार, मोहब्बत. आज इसी तरह की लाइफ जीने वाली, जिसने अपनी लाइफ को फुली जिया है, एक हमारी बहुत ही रिमार्केबल गेस्ट हैं हमारे स्टूडियो पर, जिनको मैं बुलाना चाहूँगी. उनका नाम है एनी कोशी. सो लेट्स वेलकम एनी कोशी.
You're the light, you're the night, you're the color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much, so much. You're the fear, I don't care, 'cause I've never been so high. Follow me through the dark, let me take you past us.
Hello, Annie.
Hi, Anju.
Welcome to our studio.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
By the way, you're looking beautiful. Your gown.
Did you need some material?
I think it looks pretty awesome on you. So
you.
I think I'll just let it be there.
Thank you.
Let me introduce you to our audience. Annie is an award-winning model, actress, photographer, media professional, and with a flair of community leadership. She has done two films already as an actress. Her first film was A Bloody Mess, which won over 30 nominations and awards. And recently she's done a documentary biopic, and the name of that film is
Fear.
Face Everything and Rise. So that's a film, I think it's your story, right?
That's right.
So it's the story about her, and it's amazing that she had the courage to do the film. A lot of us think about it, talk about it, but don't have that, you know, courage to do it. So I'm so glad that Annie's here with us. Not only that, she's also EMC. She also sings in English songs, which she has surprised us a few times. And so many other things she does. I mean, on this show, I can't even mention all of them. There's so many. So I'd like to welcome again our guest here on the show, Annie Koshi.
Thank you, Anju. So, is that me that you were talking about? I'm not sure.
I think that was not actually enough, Annie. But I'm so glad that you've come in the month of February, first of all, because February is a month of love. And you know, when we talk about love, we think of roses, red, beautiful people, and who else would I invite but my dear friend, Annie Koshi.
You're very sweet. Thank you so much. Yes, it's one of my favorite months. I think But unlike many people who think that they should only do it in February, I truly feel, Anju, that you should celebrate love every single day, and that you should celebrate people and those that you care about and those that you love in every single moment. And that's really the motto by which I live.
Actually, Annie, you and I go back a long way, and I actually met you, I believe, probably 6 years ago.
I think it's even longer than that. But yes, so we can, let's keep it at that. Let's keep it at six.
And we've talked a lot, and even in our weakest moments. And from that point on, you've also become an author. Not only the films you've done, you've also become an author. And you wrote a book, which I read recently, and the book is called How to Be Your Badass Self. So here's the book I want to show my audience, How to Be Your Badass Self. My question to you is, from the time I met you, how did you become a badass self?
I think I was always badass. I think that character was always in me, that person was always there. But you know, when life happens and you growing up, especially coming from a very Orthodox family and also from a community that we sort of toe the expectations of others, I put that person aside, and I didn't really meet that little girl who was sitting in the corner till I was a lot older, you know, Anju. And the book came about, the full title of the book is How to Be Your Badass Self, A Guide to Using Your Inner Energy for Brand Success. And the book actually was a culmination of years of my work, really, Anju. It was years of things that I started to do because I didn't have the source or the resources around me to help me. And so I had to rely on myself. I had to learn some of those things on myself. And then I started to become a source of inspiration. People would approach me and ask me for help. And it was at that point that I realized that I needed to take the knowledge that was in my head and put it down on paper, because it was actually becoming a guide to people.
Very nice. And I have read most of your book, and really, really inspiring. And what I like about it, Annie, is that it's, I know we've read those things in different books. It's not that it's, everything is brand new.
Exactly.
But the way you have, you know, put it together, and the way, in a simple way, you have explained. And also what I like about it, you're very clear in your lines. When you read your book, you basically know exactly what to do. So that's what I found in your book, that is very clear instructions, very simple, no-nonsense ideas which must be done in life to go somewhere. So I think your book is going to be inspiration and probably a guide to just ordinary people who are not working, and even to professional people, and I would say even to companies.
Absolutely.
So really, really very, very, very nice book.
Thank you. The book really, Anju, explores, like you mentioned, the concepts are simple. And that itself on its own is the challenge, because you seem, when you read it and you see that the concept is simple, yes, but when you combine all of these simple concepts, it does become complex.
Yes.
And so the challenge really is not really about understanding the concept. A lot of it is common knowledge. It is the application of,
yes,
these concepts in a series or in a format that makes it more complex. The challenge for most people is that they put one thing into practice, mm-hmm, and then they don't carry forward with that practice, and so it doesn't become a habit.
Yeah.
So how do you create practices? How do you take things? Another thing is, with COVID, what's happened is that a lot of people found themselves derailed. A lot,
yeah,
of individuals found themselves grandfathered with the work that they were doing, and they found themselves having to move into a digital world without the skills that they needed in order,
yes,
to navigate,
absolutely,
in that digital world.
Mm-hmm.
And so the book explores, how do you take something like your personal brand, what you're interested in, and extrapolate that into a business brand? And how do you do that consistently? And that word is the most important. The consistency of what you do is going to decide whether your brand is actually going to be able to stand out and stand apart from all the other people who are doing probably similar or same things.
You are absolutely right, Annie, because reading something and understanding and is one thing, but putting it in practice is what we need to do. But what I like about your book is that, first of all, sometimes we read books, they are very complex, and we don't even know how to do it. So what I like about your book is that it is easy to understand, and the way you have explained it's like we are actually, it's almost like reading a story. Like I'm actually, you know, it's going to happen for me. It's going to make it happen. Yeah. So how do I put one thing, next thing, and it's going to happen. So very clear, very clear. Simply explained, clear, yes, complex when you start putting it in practice, but the way you have done it, I'm very, very impressed by it.
Thank you. I think storytelling, all of us have stories to share, and if you look at how information was passed on in the olden days, we shared stories. And stories, if you're able to share your work through a form of a story, then you're able to reach an audience and you're able to help them see and believe in your story. When you start doing that, you start resonating with them. The story becomes believable. The concepts then become easy to apply because you can actually put yourself in that story. So when you progress through the chapters of the book, you're actually seeing the actual application of those concepts in how I applied it in my work. And so it's not something in which you're reading something and someone has a concept and they haven't actually practiced it. In this case, Anju, the concepts have been practiced. They have been tested. They have gone through that test of time. And I'm actually speaking about things that I've actually experienced myself. Right. And therefore, it makes it applicable. And I'm speaking then, therefore, from a place of authenticity.
And one thing I do want to mention, so I was reading on page 31, it said, what has happened in the past is a point of reference and not the failure. And then it said, your past is a stepping stone, not a stumbling block. So I was really, really impressed by this particular sentences, because a lot of us, when we fail in something, we give up, or we don't have the courage, or we don't have the, you know, security to go and take the step again. We get afraid. But what you've said is that don't look at it that way. It's a failure, but it's a stepping stone. So it was a very good line. I was really, my attention was very much caught with that, because I think that happens to all of us.
Absolutely. So when you're looking at failure, Anju, I really think that my motto is about failing forward. So what does failing forward really mean? What's the concept of failing forward? It means that you're not waiting for perfection. If you wait for perfection, those moments are going to go away. So when you take that first step, even if you know that something isn't quite perfect yet, but you take that first step and you make a mistake, you're going to learn far more from making that mistake than if you didn't take that step in the first place. So if you look at your things that happened in the past and look at those moments as being boulders in your way or your journey, then you're going to get stuck there. But if you look at those moments as ways that you were able to overcome, go over it, go around it, go under it, find a way to overcome those instances and learn from them and grow from them, then you're going to find that your journey is going to be a lot more enriched.
And one question about your film. How did you think of doing that? Or was it something spur of a moment? Or was it something you've been planning for a long time?
I don't think I really expected to have a film on my life, at least not 5 years ago or 4 years ago. I think the film came out because I wanted to use my experiences as an example in which other women and other individuals could actually learn from it. It's about having a divine purpose. It's about having that definiteness of purpose. I'm a product of Napoleon Hill Foundation and the teachings of Napoleon Hill. I'm a certified Napoleon Hill Institute student. And therefore, the teachings that I've learned showed me that I needed to really focus on what was my definiteness of purpose. What was it that I truly wanted to do? And I needed to remain focused on that. But I didn't want to use my experiences, Anju, as a place of finding fault with others. I wanted to use my experiences as a way to teach how we should or should not be, and how we need to find that courage within us to believe and do what we dream of doing, regardless of what other people, our community, our religion, our family, and perhaps even our partners say that we can or cannot do.
I believe that we all have this gift within us, and it is our need to share that gift with the world. And so the film really came about as more of an educational piece where people can use it as a tool to learn about the story of a migrant girl, myself in this case, and how I was able to overcome a lot of challenges through the course of my life and finally accomplished all of those things that I set out to do at the beginning and had a dream about doing. And that,
on a lighter note, since you are here,
you've got a spark in your eye.
So we have something here. I want actually my audience to know the real Annie Koshy.
Are you sure they want to know?
I think they want to know.
I don't think there's
So I have some surprise hot seat questions here, which we're going to ask you. Okay, Annie, our first question is, fancy dinner or movie at home?
Movie at home.
Okay. Second question, teddy bear or jewelry?
Jewelry. Of course the diva's going to come out.
Leather or lace?
Oh, lace. No, leather. Oh, both.
Why?
Because leather and lace, how can you divide the two? I wear them both.
Okay. Courtship or marriage?
Courtship. Oh my gosh. Romance in the month of...
I knew you would say that. Why courtship?
Because it's so romantic. How can courtship, all the stuff, it's... Oh gosh, this is a
You mean
PG.
Marriage is not romantic?
It is, but sometimes, you know what? When you get the prize, you don't value the prize. But in courtship, you don't know if you have the prize yet, and so you strive for the prize. That effort, which most people should carry on even throughout marriage, happens usually just during courtship. Now, if you can think of your marriage as a lifelong courtship, then you've got a winning combination.
Okay, now that's a very diplomatic answer. I really wanted to know what you think of this. Okay, love or money?
Love.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
Okay. Three words to describe Annie.
Hopeless romantic.
One more.
Ah, hopeless romantic.
Okay. You're winning most of them. I think one I wasn't too happy about. Last question, which is the winning question. Chocolate or sex?
Oh my gosh, you're making me blush. You do know I'm Indian. but you could always put those two together too.
Well, this is the winning question, Annie. You get a prize if you win
goodness.
This one.
My audience is going to gasp in horror. Sex for sure.
Okay. Okay, you got it. You actually won the round. Only this question made it happen. Okay, so what I brought you, because you won the round, I brought you, since you're wearing red, would you like this hat?
Oh, I've got a hat with a heart. Or I have a hat with
there
a...
There you go. And you also get a chocolate.
Thank you very much.
Did you bring me a gift?
Well, Anju, I didn't bring a gift. Just spending some time with you is a gift.
So since you have not brought me anything, I think there's something you can do for
What's
me.
What's that?
Well, you know, in our show, In Jeele Zindagi, we do have a segment which is called Creative Corner. And a lot of times we have artists come in, we create different kind of, art and different things. But today, because of COVID, we are not getting too many guests here. And I do have, by chance, a creative corner set up. So you can actually paint me a rose and give it to me. I'll treasure it.
Lovely.
And I'll think that you brought me something.
Absolutely. Happy
okay,
to do
so
that.
Let me show you our creative corner. करूंगी। कहते हैं दिल का रास्ता पेट से गुजरता है, और आए कुछ पेट की भी बात हो जाए, क्योंकि हमारे शो पर हम दिखाते हैं हेल्थ इज वेल्थ। तो आज तो प्यार का मौसम है, प्यार के दिन हैं, फरवरी का महीना है, तो कुछ प्यारा सा मैं भी बना के एनी को खिलाना चाहती हूँ, क्योंकि आज ये मेरे स्टूडियो में आई है और प्यार का महीना है। चाहिए गिफ्ट नहीं लाई थी, लेकिन बहुत अच्छा रोज़ बना दिया है इसने, तो इसको माफ़ कर दिया मैंने और इस रोज़ को मैं संभाल के रखने वाली हूँ। तो आओ चलते हैं, कुछ खाने पीने की बात करते हैं। वेलकम टू माई किचन इन द जीले जिंदगी शो। आई डू क्विक थ्रिफ्ट हेल्दी कुकिंग, और हेयर वी आर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ डू आई कुक अंडर 15 मिनट्स। आई डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू स्पेंड 15 मिनट्स लॉन्गर देन 15 मिनट्स इन द किचन, बिकॉज आई हैव सो मेनी थिंग्स टू डू, एंड आई एम श्योर लॉट ऑफ यू आर वर्किंग वुमेन एंड इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू यू नो टेक आउट द टाइम, बट एट द सेम टाइम यू वॉन्ट टू ईट हेल्दी and you want to, you know, be fit. So I will give you recipes on all of my shows to have that meal which is under 15 minutes and it's going to taste delicious. So today, Annie, I have a guest who's beautiful guest here in red, and we are in the month of Valentine.
I do have a question for mm-hmm. you, Anju. It looks beautiful here, but do you seriously show up into your kitchen looking like this? Like, every day?
Actually, I do. Don't you watch the soap operas? You know, Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi? This is how I go to bed. Yes.
For those of you who think that we show up into our kitchens looking like this, it's not quite the fact. But you've got an amazing spread here. I'm excited. What are you making for us today?
I'm making fish and salad. So, which is, fish is more for the protein part of our meal, and salad
so
is there.
So, are you fishing for someone?
I've already fished for you, Annie. Already fished. So, now I have the fish right here.
Caught.
You caught. That's right. And do you want to know how I did this?
Yeah, absolutely. Looks great. Like,
yeah, so I want to tell the audience that I got this new gadget here, which it's not that I'm advertising this, guys, but this is an amazing machine I find. It's called air fryer. I'm sure most of you have it. If you don't, grab one, because my life has become so simple after I got this machine. So here I have, of course, I've got the salad. This is what I've used for the salad, Annie. We have some greens here. We have peppers, we have tomatoes, we have orange. And what I've done is I've chopped it already. And I've made a salad here, and there's some blueberries on it as well. So it gives you lots of veggies. You know, they say that 3/4 of our plate should be covered with veggies. So, sorry, ye kaatna galat bol diya main. Yeah, this is going to be cut, yeah. So according to Canadian Nutrition Guide, half of our plate should be filled with vegetables, quarter of the plate should be filled with protein, and the other quarter should be filled with carbs. So what I have here is protein and salads, and carbs you can eat at home. I don't have carbs here because I'm trying to cut down on carbs. But here is the salad, Annie, with peppers, berries, it has tomatoes, it has greens, and I have this homemade salad dressing, which I use balsamic vinegar, and I also use lemon and salt and pepper. So I've already made it at home and I brought it here. And when you, what you do is just a tablespoon of balsamic vinegar, tablespoon of lemon, and a pinch of salt and pinch of pepper. Now I do have fish and I have for vegetarians tofu here. So for the protein part of this meal, you can use either or. If you are a vegetarian, you can use tofu, or if you are a, you know, you can eat meat, then you can eat fish. So what I've done, Annie, so maybe I'll show you. There are some breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is, I'll have Annie help me here since she is the guest of the show. You can put some salt in.
Into this?
Yes.
Is there an amount?
Or yeah, I've already measured. It's about a tablespoon. Okay. Teaspoon. Mm-hmm. And we have a teaspoon of red pepper.
Okay.
And then we have a teaspoon of garlic salt.
These are large teaspoons.
Actually, this is for more than one fish, actually. So what we normally do is we mix it.
Okay.
Yeah. And yeah. And I have a cod here. As you can see, there's a cod and there is a tofu. So we have already sliced that, the tofu. So what we do is we just coat that.
Okay.
With this mixture, and we put a little bit of oil so that the coating stays on, and I'll put that in there if this thing opens. A little bit of that, yeah. And I will also put a little bit of balsamic vinegar on the tofu, not on the fish.
Okay,
just a little, and you can put this tofu on this after it's done. I'm putting tofu in first because the people who are vegetarian would not want something if I've used fish before. So there we go. So we'll take this out and we can just put it here. This is all marinated. Okay. And the same thing we will do with the fish. Okay. Now I did not open this fish yet. So same thing we'll do with the fish. So as you can see, I have it here. I've already done that, what you've just done.
Okay.
So they're already ready to go. And all I'm going to do it is stick it in the air fryer for 8 minutes. Depends on the air fryer again. We'll start with 6. And if it's not cooked, we use another 2 minutes. So always start with a little bit less time so that it doesn't get burned.
Anju, your air fryer, I think I could fit in there. Are you trying to fry people in there?
Well, you know what? This is a medium size, Annie.
If you could put rollers on the bottom of that, you could use that as carry-on luggage.
That's right. Actually, that's a good idea. You can put your socks and whatever in it and take it with you, you know, if you're traveling.
Maybe you can carry it as your hand luggage. Like,
Well, I don't know about the hand luggage. It's kind of round. But there is a smaller one you can get, Annie, if you want just for yourself. I know you are single, so you want a smaller one. They do have a smaller one. So all we're going to do is cook now, and then we'll show you what it looks like.
So does it go, do you have to put oil in there?
No. No oil.
Okay.
Yeah, it's easy. As I said, under 15 minutes is what we... Oh, this is not the right tool here. I should have used this one. Okay, so I'm going to turn this on at 400 for 6 minutes. Cut here, bhai, because this is going to make a noise. I also have to see. Without glasses is always hard. Let's do 7.
And start it?
Yeah, it will start itself.
Oh, really?
There. You learn something every day, my dear.
I have it at home. I just have to take it out of the box. I have one. It's like one of those things. It's like
she doesn't bring me any gift. Doesn't take out the fryer out of the box.
Well, I'm waiting for you to cook me a meal. You said we've known each other for half a century.
COVID. It looks like that. Is it that long?
But
people say that when they're married.
Oh, I know.
gosh, are we starting to look like each other? Gosh, that's a comment we have to wait and work on. But yes, this seems like a wonderful thing. The only concern that I would have for myself is the amount of space that it takes up.
Do you find you're using it all? Do you find I use it every day. Okay. So you get a smaller one, which is for one or two people.
Okay.
If you invite me, you can cook for two.
I like how she just slid that in there, you know, like very conveniently just sort of slotted in there.
I know, because I've been waiting for that invitation.
Right. I am a good cook, but I do traditional cooking or fusion cooking, I would say.
I know, I've seen it on the Facebook.
I cook with love. That's what it is.
This is love too, Annie.
Absolutely.
Come on, like, I mean, look at it.
I think for many families, food is a way of sharing and spreading love, and it's really quite inspiring to see that we find any opportunity really to break bread with
That's
our friends.
Right.
We
That's
break
right.
bread with our those that we love, and for me, any meeting has to be around food, or it's not going to be a successful meeting. So if you're planning on meeting me, that's something to think about, right?
That's right. So so it's going to take about 6 or 7 minutes. I put it on salmon. Let's see what it does. So according to your air fryer, you know, you have to kind of see, you have to try it and see how long it takes. But usually I think the times are pretty same for all the air fryers. So as you can see, I cooked it for 7 minutes at 400 degrees and it looks done. And because you want to make sure it's juicy, you don't want to overcook it. Mm-hmm. So look how nice it looks.
Absolutely.
You can see, so we'll place it here. And I have a tofu here as well. Now tofu, we used a little bit of balsamic vinegar, so it looks a little dark, but it is not overcooked. So we'll put that on the salad for a vegetarian dish.
Looks great.
And voila, the food is ready. Now you can put your salad dressing a little bit, whatever you like on the salad. And if you like, you can also have a little bit of hummus and you can have pita with it, just to have the carbs. I did not bring the carbs because I personally want to cut down on the carbs these days. So there you go. So it has all the nutrients, all the vitamins, and also protein here. And it's a great meal. It can be lunch or dinner. मोटे मुद्दे चटपटी गपशप कलाकारों से मुलाकात कुछ जीने और कुछ खाने की बात तो क्यों ना हो जाए आपका और हमारा साथ और देखते रहिए हमें हर वीक हम आते हैं और आपके लिए कुछ नया कुछ चटपटा लेके आते हैं और हमारे गेस्ट भी बहुत ही अच्छे होते हैं और इस शो के साथ जुड़े रहिए देखना मत भूलिएगा फिर से आएंगे नेक्स्ट वीक इसी टाइम पर और मिलेंगे आप सब से और जाने से पहले लास्ट चीज हम करते हैं एक सेल्फी मोमेंट विद आवर गेस्ट सो आए करते हैं सेल्फी मोमेंट हेलो एवरीवन आप देख रहे हैं स्टूडियो 4 प्रोडक्शंस जीले जिंदगी With your host Anju Malhotra. कहते हैं कि जिंदगी में उत्साह भरने के लिए और हमेशा एक्साइटमेंट रखने के लिए कुछ ना कुछ नया करना ज़रूरी होता है और नई नई जगह जाना भी बहुत ज़रूरी होता है और आज उसी तरह से हम इसको जीने के लिए आज एक जगह पे आए हैं जो एक छोटा सा विलेज है कनाडा का जी हाँ विलेज और इसको कहते हैं स्ट्रीट्सविल और स्ट्रीट्सविल की कुछ हिस्ट्री इस तरह से है मैं आपको बताती हूँ कि ये 1818 में जो हमारे यहाँ पे क्रेडिट रिवर है उसके आसपास का काफ़ी सारा एरिया थाउजेंड्स ऑफ एकर्स वर गिवन टू ब्रिटिश एंड यू नो ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट हैड टेकन दैट एंड उनको उसका सर्वे करना था तो उन्होंने एक सर्वेयर को बुलाया जो कि नायग्रा में रहता था और उसका नाम था टिमथी स्ट्रीट टिमथी स्ट्रीट ने उसका सारा सर्वे किया जो लैंड ब्रिटिश को दी गई थी और जब वो सर्वे किया उसने तो उसको 1000 एकड़ जो था दिया गया सर्वे करने के लिए, आई गेस आजकल तो कोई एक फुट भी नहीं देता, पर जी हाँ उसको दिया गया 1000 एकड़ सर्वे करने के लिए। तो वो 1000 एकड़ जो था वो ये सारा इस एरिया स्ट्रीट्सविल एरिया में आता है। और कहते हैं कि उसके बाद क्या हुआ कि 1824 में इस एरिया का नाम उन्होंने स्ट्रीट्सविल रखा, लेकिन ये विलेज ऑफ स्ट्रीट्सविल था और 1973 तक ये विलेज ऑफ स्ट्रीट्सविल ही रहा। और 1974 में इसको मिसिसागा के साथ मिला दिया गया। जी हाँ, मिसिसागा जो बहुत बड़ा सिटी है हमारे टोरंटो का, सॉरी कनाडा का, उसके साथ इसको मिला दिया गया। और इसकी जो उस टाइम मेयर थी वो होती थी हेजल मकैलियन, और आप जैसा जानते होंगे कि हेजल मकैलियन हमारे मिसिसागा की भी मेयर रही हैं फॉर इयर्स एंड इयर्स। तो क्योंकि वो यहाँ पे 3 साल से मेयर थी, उनको जब मिसिसागा में स्ट्रीट्सविल मिला तो उनको मिसिसागा का मेयर बना दिया गया। तो बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी है इस विलेज की, लेकिन अभी भी हम इसको विलेज ही कहते हैं। सो स्ट्रीट्सविल विलेज जो अब मिसिसागा के अंदर आ गया है। तो आप देख रहे हैं हम खड़े हैं स्ट्रीट्सविल स्क्वायर में। ये जो जगह है ये बहुत ही लाइवली जगह है। आज तो हम विंटर में खड़े हैं तो यहाँ पे बहुत कम लोग हैं, लेकिन समर में यहाँ पे बैंड होता है, म्यूजिक होता है, बहुत कुछ हो रहा होता है और बहुत सारे फेस्टिवल्स होते हैं इस एरिया में। तो आप मेरे पीछे देख रहे होंगे कि बहुत सारी दुकानें हैं और कैफेज़ हैं, म्यूजिक स्कूल है, लेकिन ये अभी आजकल बहुत सारी दुकानें बंद हैं क्योंकि कोविड का टाइम है। लेकिन आप देख रहे होंगे कि इसको इन्होंने हिस्ट्री को मेंटेन किया है, क्योंकि ये विलेज है तो वो नहीं चाहते कि बड़ी बड़ी बिल्डिंगें बना दी जाएं। हिस्ट्री को मेंटेन किया गया है। और हेजल मकैलियन जो हमारी मेयर मिसिसागा में बहुत साल तक रही हैं, उनके जो हस्बैंड थे उनका नाम था सैम मकैलियन। तो सैम 1973 में उन्होंने प्रपोज किया कि यहाँ पे ब्रेड एंड बटर का फेस्टिवल होना चाहिए। तो ब्रेड एंड बटर के फेस्टिवल की भी एक हिस्ट्री है, क्योंकि जो मैंने बात की थी टिमथी स्ट्रीट, जिस आदमी ने यहाँ पे जिसको 1000 एकड़ दिया गया था, उन्होंने एक मिल लगाई थी यहाँ पे जिसका फ्लावर की मिल थी वो। और इनफैक्ट स्ट्रीट्सविल में काफ़ी मिल्स थी, अबाउट 5 मिल्स तो कुछ साल पहले भी यहाँ थी, और उस मिल्स के आसपास बहुत लोग काम करने आते थे। तो वो उन्होंने फ्लावर की मिल लगाई थी, तो उन्हीं के लिए उन्होंने ब्रेड और जो हनी फेस्टिवल है वो शुरू किया। सो वो पिछले 49 ईयर से यहाँ पे वो फेस्टिवल हो रहा है, सॉरी 48 ईयर से, क्योंकि 1973 से वो पहला फेस्टिवल शुरू हुआ था। और लगातार हर साल उसमें बहुत कुछ होता है, बड़े फंड रेज किए जाते हैं, बैंड्स आते हैं, वेंडर्स आते हैं, खूब रौनक होती है स्ट्रीट्सविल में, और ये एक ट्रेडिशन बन गया है स्ट्रीट्सविल का। तो हिस्ट्री को मेंटेन करते हुए विलेज की लाइफ थोड़ी सी वैसे ही है यहाँ पे, कोई अबाउट 50-60 हज़ार के करीब यहाँ पे लोग रहते हैं। तो आप देखेंगे कि जब आप यहाँ आएंगे तो बहुत लोग जो यहाँ के लोकल्स हैं वो अभी भी थोड़ा काफ़ी पुराने टाइप से ड्रेसअप होते हैं। आज मैं आपको दिखा नहीं पा रही बिकॉज बहुत ठंड है आज, ये कनाडा है यू नो, तो आज यहाँ पे -13 टेम्परेचर है और बहुत सर्दी लग रही है। और अभी मैं ढूंढ रही थी कि कोई कॉफ़ी की दुकान मिल जाए, और कैफ़े भी ऑलमोस्ट बंद है, शायद एक आज कोई खुला हो, अभी हम जाके कॉफ़ी लेंगे। तो ये थोड़ी हिस्ट्री है स्ट्रीट्सविल की। और ये भी बताना चाहती हूँ कि जो फेस्टिवल यहाँ होते हैं उसमें काफ़ी गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स भी आते हैं और आके कुछ ना कुछ, ये हर महीने होता रहता है यहाँ। अभी भी यहाँ पे जो स्ट्रीट्सविल BIA है, बिजनेस एसोसिएशन जो है, उन्होंने एक कॉन्टेस्ट रखा हुआ है जिसमें अगर आप वर्चुअल स्नोमैन के साथ पिक्चर खिंचा के आप उनको टैग करते हैं और हैशटैग करते हैं तो आपको गिफ्ट मिल सकता है, इनाम मिल सकता है, आप विनर भी हो सकते हैं। तो ज्वाइन करिए इनकी फेस्टिविटीज में, बहुत ही मजा आता है। सो सर, कैन आई टॉक टू यू फॉर अ मिनट?
श्योर। Yeah, no problem.
How long have you been in Streetsville?
I grew up my whole life here. Yeah, on and off, for sure.
Okay, 40 years?
Yeah.
How about this church? How long has been there, St. Andrew's Church?
I think the plaque's 1860s in there somewhere. So Timothy Street, who founded the area, is buried in the cemetery of the size. So anyway, that's the...
Okay.
Yeah, it's nice to look at.
Tell us a little bit about what do you think of love?
I think it's important to a happy life, I would say. Yeah.
Oh, wow, that's a great answer. And do you think love lasts? Does it stay steamy for a long, long time, or does it cool down?
I think it definitely lasts. You have to define steamy, and that's probably another conversation.
Yeah. Okay. Hello again. So, jo hum mills ki baat kar rahe the, ke Streetsville mein 5 mills thi aur kuch aur bhi choti mills thi. To mere piche jo hai, ye sabse badi mill yahan pe hai. Abhi bhi ye yahan pe maujood hai aur iska naam hai Ardent Mills. और हम ब्रेड और हनी के फेस्टिवल की जो बात करते हैं, लॉट ऑफ फ्लावर जो है इस मिल से आता है और वीट का काफ़ी यहाँ पे वीट और कुछ और ग्रेन्स के यहाँ पे फ्लावर बनाया जाता है और वो यूज़ किया जाता है ब्रेड और हनी फेस्टिवल में. सो इसी तरह बहुत सारी और भी मिल्स इस स्ट्रीट्सविल में थी. कुछ अब बंद हो गई हैं ओवर द ईयर्स और कुछ अभी भी चल रही हैं. सो अब हम खड़े हैं एक टी रूम के सामने. ये मेरे पीछे जो बिल्डिंग है, ये पहले लाइब्रेरी होती थी बहुत साल पहले, और अब इसको कन्वर्ट कर दिया गया है. इसमें अभी भी एक बुक शॉप है छोटी सी, पीछे बुक्स हैं, बहुत पुरानी पुरानी बुक्स हैं इनफैक्ट. लेकिन उसके आगे टी रूम बना दिया गया है, जो बहुत क्यूट सा टी रूम है. बहुत इसमें ओल्ड चाइना यूज़ होता है चाय पीने के लिए, और आप अगर कभी ऐसे बड़ी यू नो कोजी सी चाय पीना चाहें तो ये टी रूम बहुत ही अच्छा है. ऐसे ही और भी बहुत सारे टी रूम्स और कैफेज़ हैं स्ट्रीट्सविल में, और इनफैक्ट स्ट्रीट्सविल में ऑलमोस्ट 300 कैफेज़ और छोटी छोटी शॉप्स हैं, लोकल शॉप्स, जिनमें आप कुछ भी जाके खरीद सकते हैं. और वो भी छोटी बुक स्टोर्स हैं, बच्चों की शॉप्स हैं, और नेल्स की और कॉस्मेटिक की बहुत छोटी छोटी, और कपड़ों की शॉप्स हैं, और बहुत ही प्यारी सी शॉप्स हैं, और थोड़ी हिस्ट्री मेंटेन करके रखती हैं. तो अंदर जो डेकोर है वो भी थोड़ा हिस्टोरियन है, और बिल्डिंग्स भी हिस्ट्री मेंटेन करके रखी हुई हैं. तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है, इसमें विलेज की एक फील आती है. आप ये नहीं सोचते कि आप बड़े सिटी में हैं. और अब हम हैं स्ट्रीट्सविल के क्रेडिट रिवर के एरिया में, जहाँ के जहाँ पे बहुत सारी ट्रेल्स हैं उसके आसपास, और लोग हाइकिंग के लिए, वॉक करने के लिए इस एरियाज में आते हैं. और आप देख सकते हैं कि बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल ये छोटा सा विलेज है, और रिवर के आसपास बहुत कुछ बना भी हुआ है. अगेन कैफेज, चर्चेज, और लोग घूमने आते हैं छोटे टाउन को देख, छोटे से विलेज को देखने आते हैं. और इस टाइम विंटर है तो हमारे ट्रीज बिल्कुल ग्रीन नज़र नहीं आ रहे, नहीं तो यहाँ पे बहुत ग्रीनरी होती है और ट्रेल्स बहुत ही सुंदर लगती हैं. इस टाइम विंटर में हमें ठंड भी लग रही है, और ट्रीज में कोई लीफ भी नहीं है और सन भी नहीं है. तो अब हम चलेंगे, थोड़ा कॉफ़ी पीते हैं. My crew was giving me hard time, but finally I did get my coffee. Thank you very much for watching.